Hello, Dominic from BMT Spain with part 11 of all the technical variations we can find in the surf. Today, the second part of the shoulder turn. The first part was the loading part. This part is the unloading part, or the part where the shoulder starts to turn towards contact. But the real shoulder turn starts after the leg drive. Now, before I come back to that, I will show you a few different ways to turn that shoulder, which we will need when we are going to explain some top players. Now, the first way to turn that shoulder is to turn the complete body. This is also the surf we see a lot with the recreational players. It seems like this. And they are turning the whole body towards that contact. Another part is where you also start in that position. The difference is that now my shoulder and my hip are in the same line. So you start to turn that body. My hip will stop so that my shoulder can accelerate towards that contact. And it goes like this. So as you could see, this was already a faster surf. Now, another way is where you have more shoulder turn. The two before, the shoulder line and the hip line were the same. Now we will create more shoulder turn, more space between the hip and the shoulder. And again here, when we go up, the shoulder will catch up to the hip, and then the whole body will turn against the ball like this. Which is also a decent serve. This is more for women. We will see that later. And then another one is, which is used more by men, is that the hip goes first and then the shoulder follows. So the hip goes first and then the shoulder follows, more like this. And as you could see, even a stronger serve. Now, to come back to our players, in the first video for the shoulder turn, we talked about Rajonic. And we have seen that Rajonic is in a more of a 45 degree angle, but it's not because of his shoulder turn. He has more a body turn, and this is more because of his position. You will see we will use three different positions, and you will see difference in serve. Now Rajonic, because he's more in that position, he has more body turn, and more body turn is that the hip and the shoulders stay more in the same line. Check out his position. So, we have seen that he has body turn and not a lot of shoulder turn, because if Rajonic would have more shoulder turn, his shoulders would be parallel to the baseline and they are in the same angle of the hip. Now, if we check out Djokovic, who has a little different in stance, you will see that they already start to have a little more space between the hip and the shoulder. Let's check out his position. So, we have seen more space, which is already starting to create a little more tension, a little more stretch in the abdominals. But let's check out Janovic. Check it out. Now, Janovic was not in this or that position. His position, his right foot was more in front, creating more space between the hip and the shoulder, which will create more stretching, and that stretch will result in a faster shoulder turn. Now, I told you that the shoulder turn starts after the leg drive. Check out the position of Rajonic. So, here we have seen that after the leg drive, the shoulder and the hip, there wasn't a lot of variation in it, so he had also in that leg drive more body turn, and his hip was still pointing in that direction the moment he had that leg drive. Now, let's check out Djokovic. Djokovic, what was the difference? Djokovic was the one who starts with that hip, keeping that shoulder backwards, and by that creating more stretch here in the abdominals, which will result in a faster shoulder turn, the same as Janovic has. Let's check out Janovic. But the difference with Janovic is because of his foot position, his hip, the moment he has that leg drive done, he's almost parallel to the baseline. Now, the moment I touch the ball, let's check out Raonic. So we have seen that Raonic in contact point, his hip is still pointing there. So he was the one who had more body turn where the hip blocks and then the shoulder keeps turning. Then we have seen Djokovic where his hip in that leg drive was there and then he blocks also that hip and has more that shoulder turn, and is the same with Janovic. Because of his foot position, he's almost parallel to that baseline. Now, the other one, I don't have a good picture from behind. It's more that when I said it's more the women's serve, is Serena, who has more that part. Then she goes up, the shoulder catches up, and then the whole body turn. But let's check it out from the side. So you could see that the moment that Serena made contact, that the hips were parallel to the baseline. So she is using more that body turn than only that shoulder turn. But let's check out some more pictures. So we have seen that more women are using that body turn, where more men are using a little more that shoulder turn. So again, it's up to you guys. Go out, try, or with a little more body turn, or with a little more shoulder turn. It's up to you. Try to feel if there are differences, if it helps you. But for today, the only thing I can say, thank you for watching. See you in the next video. I do want to do a little extra and show you the difference between the shoulder turn in a flat serve and in a kick serve. So let's start with the flat serve. Here you see that shoulder position and that hip position. Now let's go and check out what's that shoulder and hip position in a kick serve. And as you can see here, there is no shoulder and hip turn until after contact. So again, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.